Welcome to the tutorial on PERT. PERT stands for Program Evaluation and Review Technique. So it is Program Evaluation and Review Technique. It is based on three time constraints. One is TO, TM and TP. So TO stands for optimistic time and TM stands for most likely time and P stands for pessimistic time. So what is T0? So T0 is like optimistic time. It is the time that is shortest possible time required for completion of an activity. If all goes well, we can go for TO. What is pessimistic time? The maximum possible time the activity will take if everything goes bad. So it is opposite of TO. And mostly, most likely time is the time an activity will take if executed under normal condition in a modal value, or in between, we can call it as in between TO and TP. So optimistic time is like if everything goes well, we can go for optimistic time. If everything is not goes well, it is said to be pessimistic time. So in between we have something called as TM. So they will give a value like this in the question itself, and so we have to identify this thing. We have to identify the project network, and we have to identify the expected project length, and we have to calculate the standard deviation like dou and variance called mu, and what is the probability that the project will be completed at least 4 weeks or no more than 4 weeks. If the project due date is 19 weeks, what is the probability of not getting the not meeting the due date, or if the project due date is 19 weeks? So what we have to do is we have to use to solve this D and E, we have to use this table called statistical table. So in this statistical table we have to use something called as normal distribution table, and we will see this later. So we will solve this problem. So first one is we have to draw the project network. So first thing is we have to draw the project network. So the network is given like we have a many number of nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the activity is like from 1 to 2, they have given 1, 1, 7. So it is can be written like this, 1, 1, 7. The first value is optimistic time, the second value is most likely time, and the third value is pessimistic time. So from 1 to 2, we have 1, 1, 7. From 1 to 3, we have 1, 4, 7. From 1 to 4, we have 2, 2, 8. From 2 to 5 we have 1, 1, 1. From 3 to 5 we have 2, 5, 14. From 4 to 6 we have 2, 5, 8. From 5 to 6 we have 3, 6, 15. Sometimes what they will give is, they will give this as the data. Using this data we have to construct this table, and we can apply the formula. And the next step is, and the second thing is, so we have drawn the project network, and the second one is we have to determine the expected project length. So to identify the expected project length, we have to use two formulas. That is, the first one is TE equal to T0 plus TM plus TP by 6, and for calculating the standard deviation, dou equal to dou square equal to TP minus T0 by 6 the whole square. So this is said to be like mu, and this is said to be like standard deviation. So we will calculate for each and every activity. So now I'll be applying this here. So I'll be adding two things like TE and dou square. So the value for TE is, the formula is T naught plus 4 into Tm plus Tp by 6. So it is like 1 plus 4 plus 7 by 6. So 1 plus 4 is 5, 5 plus 7 divided by 6. It is, the value is like 9.0. Sorry, it is not 9.0, it is 1 plus 4 into 1 plus 7, it is 5 plus 7, 5 plus 7 is 12 by 6 is 2. So similarly, other values can be obtained by using this formula. So the other values are this, and dou square value is Tp minus To by 6 the whole square. The value is 1110414. So we have to calculate TE and dou square. So TE is like 1 plus 4 into Tm plus 7 by 6, it is 2. Dou square is Tp minus To by 6 the whole square, it is 7 minus 1, it is 6. 6 by 6, it is 1 square, that is 1. So to calculate the expected project length, we have to calculate this. And next step is, we have to calculate the earliest start time and the latest completion time to calculate the critical path in this graph. So what you can do is, you can put a, you can apply CPM here. So first we have to start with 0, 0, and we have to put an arrow first. So 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 2 to 5, 3 to 5, 4 to 6, then 5 to 6 like that. So here the starting node is 0, 0. And the ending node is, starting node is 1. We have earliest start time and latest completion time is 0, 0. This is fixed for the first node. And we have to calculate for others. What you have to do is, here we have three values. You should consider only the most likely value for calculating the CPM. Okay. So what we have to do is, we have to calculate this thing. So 0 we have and 1 we have. So what we have to do is, for calculating the earliest start time, we have to add this. So 0 plus 1, 1, we have 1. Since we have only one outgoing arrows, and for 3 we have only one outgoing arrow, so that is 4. So 0 plus 4 is 4. Similarly, 0 is here and 2 is here. We have only one outgoing arrow, so that is 0 plus 2 is 2. So for 5 we have outgoing arrow, one outgoing arrows. Sorry, actually we have to calculate the incoming arrows. So for 2 we have only one incoming arrow, so 0 plus 1 is 1. And for 3 we have only one incoming arrow, so 4 plus 0 is 4. For 4 we have only one incoming arrow, so 0 plus 2 is 2. For 5 we have two incoming arrow, so 1 plus 1, that is one incoming arrow. And we have 4 plus 5 is another incoming arrow, So what we have to do is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. We have to calculate the maximum of these two values. The maximum of these two values is 9. So that comes for the fifth. And for the sixth one, we have to have two incoming arrow. So one is like 9 plus 6 and another one is 2 plus 5. So 2 plus 5 is 7 and 9 plus 6 is 15. So 15 is the largest value and we have to put 15 here. So it is easy to calculate the earliest starting time. And next step is we have to calculate the latest completion time. So the last node will be like the same as the earliest completion time. It is 15:15. And next step is we have to go for 5. So what we have to go for 5 is we have to calculate the number of outgoing arrows from 5. So the number of outgoing arrow for 5 is like only 1 from 6. So we have to calculate this 15 minus 6. So 15 minus 6 is 9. So we have to put this as 9. So after that we have to go for 4. So in that 4 we have only one outgoing arrow. So outgoing arrow that goes to what, 6. So we have like 15. We have like 15 minus 5 and that yields 10. So this will be 10 and we have to go for 4. So 4 we have only one outgoing arrow. So that is 9. So we have 9 here and minus 5 we have 4. And for 2 we have only one outgoing arrow. So that is like 9 we have. So 9 minus 1 is 8. And for 1 we have 3 outgoing arrow. So 1 is 8 minus 1 and another one is 4 minus 4 and another one is 10 minus 2. So we have 7, 0 and 8. So the minimum of this 7, 0 and 8 is 0. So we have to write 0 here. So this is how we have to compute the critical path for the given network. So what we have to do is for calculating the earliest start time, we have to check for the incoming arrow. So here there is no incoming arrow for 1, we have to put 0. For incoming arrow for 2, we have only one incoming arrow. So we have to take 0 plus 1 here. Similarly for latest completion time, we have to calculate like outgoing arrow 15 minus 6 like 9, we have to calculate. Now to mark this critical path, what we have to do is we have to start from 1. After 1 we have 2, 3, 4 and you can see 2 we have 8, 1 and for 3 we have 4, 4 and for 4 we have 10, 2. Now you can see for 2 we have earliest start time and latest completion time are equal. So you mark this as the critical path and from 3 we have like only 5. 5 we have 999, so you mark from 3 to 5 as a critical path. From 5 it is connected to only 6. 6 we have 15:15, so you mark this as the critical path. So the critical path of the network is 1, 3, 5 and 6. And the expected length of the project is, we have to check for the value. From 1 to 3 the expected length is 4. Or you can calculate like this, summation of TE. So from 1 to 3 we have 4, from 3 to 5 we have 6 and from 5 to 6 we have 7. So totally we'll get project length for TE is 17. Next we have to calculate the dou square for this critical path 1, 3, 5, 6. So the dou square value is from 1 to 3 we have 1, from 3 to 5 we have 4, from 5 to 6 we have 4. So from 1 to 3 we have 1, from 3 to 5 we have 4, from 5 to 6 we have 6. So that will be 9. So dou square is equal to 9. So dou is equal to 9 or sigma is equal to 9. So we can call it as this as variance So the expected length for TE is 17 and the dou square is 9. So what we can do is we can solve the next thing. Calculate standard deviation and variance. So the variance is mu, that is we have already solved mu equal to 17, and the standard deviation is dou. Already we have calculated dou square and dou is 3. Okay, next thing is we have to calculate D. So D is like what is the probability that the project will be completed. They have given a criteria, at least 4 weeks. So the given value is 4 weeks. They have given a value at least. So if it is like at least, assume the weeks are X. If it is like at least, it can take greater than or equal to 4. Okay, so if it is like at least, it is like greater than or equal to 4. If it is like at most, if they ask like at most, it is like less than or equal to 4. So in this data, they have given at least 4 weeks. So x is greater than or equal to 4. To obtain this probability, what we have to do is, there is a formula. So z is equal to x minus mu by sigma. So at least 4 weeks the data is given, so x is equal to 4, you apply x is equal to 4 weeks like that, what we have to do is the total time is 17. So if it is like at least it is like 4 weeks, what we have to do is the given x can be written as 17 the total minus 4. So x is equal to 13. So you apply this in this formula. So 13 minus mu value is 17 by sigma value is 3. So that is equal to minus 4 by 3. That is minus 1.33. So now in this distribution we have like z is equal to minus 1.33. So now we have to take this table. It is a statistical table. So they will give in this, they will give you this in examination. So what you can do is, the value here it is like positive value, but here we got is negative value minus 1.33. So what you can do is, you can see like 1.3 here. So then you mark here and we have get like 1.33. The value for 1.33 is like 0.9082. Since the value is negative, we have to subtract this by 1. When you subtract this by 1, you will get the value. So just calculate this. So 1 minus 0.9082 will get 0.0918. So the probability is like if you multiply this by 100, you will get 9.18, like that you will get. So the probability is 9.18. So this is for at least. So if they ask like at least 4 weeks like that, first we have to subtract this by the length. So that is 14 minus 4. If it is like at least, we have to write 14 minus 4, that is 13. You apply here, 13 minus 17 is minus 4, minus 4 by 3 and minus 1.33. If it is like a negative value, go to this table and calculate 1.33 here. So 1.33 is 0.9082. you subtract that by 1, so 1 minus 0.9082, you will get this value. You multiply this by 100, you will get this 9.18 value. And the next problem is they have given the what is the probability of completion of time that takes no more than 4 weeks. If it is like no more than 4 weeks, it is like x less than or equal to 4. So you get the total estimate, the length is 17. So what you can do is the new x is equal to 17 plus 4, that is 21. You calculate z, so z is equal to x minus mu by dou. So x is equal to 21 minus mu equal to 7, mu equal to 17 by 3, we'll be getting 1.33. Now since the value is positive, go to the table and calculate 1.33 here. So 1.33 is 0.9082. So it is 0.9082. Since this value is positive, you can no need to subtract this with 1, and the probability is 19.82%. And the third one is, what if the project due is 19 weeks and what is the probability of not meeting the due date? So first we have to calculate the probability of getting the value in 19 weeks, and the total probability is 1. We have to subtract this with 1 and we'll get the solution. So here the value of x is given as 19. So what you can do is calculate z. So 19 minus mu by 19 minus mu, that is 17 by 3. We'll be getting 2 by 3. So that is 0.667, or you can round it off with 0.67. So now you go to the, since this value is positive, you can directly write from the table. So it is 0.67, it is 0.67, it is like 7486. So 0.7486. So it is 74.86%. And this is the value for 19. And what they have asked is, they have asked the probability that the completion time is not 19. So what you can do is, you can subtract it by 100%, 100 minus 74.86. The result is like 25.14. The total probability is 1, or you can subtract this with 1, 1 minus 74.86, you will get 0.25.14. So, or you can subtract this by 100 and you will get the result. And the next thing is, if the project due date is exactly 19 weeks, what happens if the project due date is exactly 19 weeks? So x is exactly given as 19 weeks. So what you can do is, z is equal to 19 minus 17 by 3, and we have got 2 by 3, we have got 6, 7. Round it off with 6, 7, and the probability table for 6, 7 is 0.67 is 7486. So it is 0.7486, and the probability is 74.86. So that's all about the problem. Just to revise what we have learned. So PERT is like a program evaluation and review technique, and they will give this three thing. One is TO, that is optimistic time, TM, that is most likely time, and TP is pessimistic time. And they will give this, we have to calculate this T and dou square, T by the formula T naught plus 4TM plus TP by 6, and dou square is TP minus T naught by 6 the whole square. And first you estimate all the values, and you construct a graph, and in this network, what you have to do is, you have to calculate the critical path by using a CPM method, and this is the formula. First you calculate the we can calculate the expected project length by summation of TE of this critical path 1, 3, 3, 5 and 5, 6, it is 17, and dou square it is 1, 3, 5, 6, that is equal to 9. And the standard deviation and variance can be calculated mu equal to that is nothing but TE, and this is nothing but square root of dou square or sigma square. So what you can do is, the next thing is, if you want to calculate the probability that the completion time is at least 4 weeks, or what you can do is, it is x greater than or equal to 4. So if it is like at least, you subtract it with the mu, that is 17 minus 4 equal to 13. So we'll get this value. So since this value is negative, you have to get the value of 1.33 from the table. You subtract it with 1 and you'll get this. And if you multiply with 100, you'll get 19.18%. And if it is like no more than 9 weeks, you add it with 17, you'll get 21. And you get up, since the value is positive, you directly write and you convert that into probability value. And if it is like exactly x is equal to 19, or if it is like not 19, if the probability is not 19, first you calculate 19 and after that you subtract it with by 100, you will get the value. And if it is like exactly 19, the same thing you have to apply. Since the value is positive, you directly write the value. So that's all about the problem. And sometimes they will ask like this also.